What follows is a portion of the audience commentary from Conversations That Matter, Teen Suicide in Alaska, a co-production of KAKM Channel 7 Television and the Alaska Community Foundation.
Hi. I wanted to thank each of you for what you're doing. I have, some may consider, the unfortunate role of sitting on one of the teams in our state that reviews child fatalities. And I also work primarily in the area of criminal child abuse. And so I guess I just wonder, in each of your efforts and in the work that you do, in my experience, it is the chronic, uninterrupted childhood trauma that lies beneath many of the suicides that I see in the files of young people in Alaska. And it's tragic, it's frustrating to be dealing with it on the end rather than when those children are 3, 4, 5, taking care of themselves, not knowing who they can trust, not having a safe person to go to. I don't know if those conversations come up in the suicide prevention arena. Some of us have certainly tried to bring them there. But we have a serious problem with sexual abuse of children in Alaska that is not being attacked with the same fervor that youth suicide is. And so I would just plead for you and ask you if in your efforts you have heard that dialogue brought up, and if you see any hope for merging those issues and really helping us intervene with children before the hopelessness sets in to the degree they don't want to live. Thank you.
Well, I can address and talked about a great program at South Central Foundation called Family Wellness Warriors Initiative. It's not for children, but it's for adults, but it is for child abuse, sexual abuse and neglect. And it really goes to that. They're week-long trainings. It's not just, you know, a couple hours. It's really getting to that core issue. And it's, again, it's called FWWI, Family Wellness Warriors Initiative. And they do merge both of those topics at some points. They do go and talk about sexual abuse and child neglect.
And this is an issue that has informed the council and the state of Alaska's work. We have heard both from attempt survivors that have experienced child sex abuse, as well as community leaders that have talked about how it has affected their communities. Here in Anchorage, there is the Child Trauma Center that provides services to small children up to adolescents to help address what they've experienced and to help heal them so that they can move past that. But not every community has that. Some communities have child advocacy centers, which provide not the same intensity of services, but often support for the victim and their family. I think that there's a combination of things. There has to be the change socially into what's acceptable and what's not. And then the services to help people heal. And so we have the program at South Central Family Wellness Warriors, and Beauty for Ashes is kind of complement. It's part of that, right?
Yeah, that's what the training is called, Beauty for Ashes. And it really addresses and gets to that core. You stay on the campus and the training, and it's all confidential. It's with trusted, trained people that you can talk to about. I mean, this is a difficult topic. It really is. And that is one of the ways that South Central Foundation is addressing that issue.
But there are certainly not resources throughout the state. I mean, I think there are attempts to expand the programs we have, but there are not resources throughout the state to deal with the harm that our children often suffer. Mm-hmm.